alone, all this was very new. And sure, there was a toucan perched up on a tree. So Otter swam towards him to ask what he could see. I've lost my otter friends while sound asleep at night. Will you help me find them? Oh, please tell me you might. Although my eyes are blind, there's magic behind me. This thing can always find whatever you may seek. Just tell me how they look, describe them well to me. My wrinkle then find out where all of them could be. But he could not recall the way they looked at all. Were they short, round, and fat, or were they thin and tall? Swimming through the tree branch, a monkey came his way. Otter, what has happened? Oh, tell me if you may. Otter told the monkey the story from the start. He said it as he sat with quite a heavy heart. That's simple, monkey said. There is one easy clue. Well, all your otter friends, they look the way you do. Here, take this leafy branch and draw the things I say. Your arms and legs are long. I see you in that way. Then Mr. Fox appeared. He said he'll help us well. The fox had things to say, yes. He had things to tell. Both your ears are pointy. Your tail is very long. Your fangs are very sharp. They look so very strong. Then came Mrs. Hedgehog to share what she could see. Your eyes are very small. What a strange way to be. Hippo looked at Otter and laughed at what he saw. Otter, you're very fat. That is what you should draw. Poor Otter sat nearby, feeling so very blue. His drawings looked like them. At least that part he knew. There must be a mistake. Some things did not seem right. Perhaps the things he drew were not based on their sight. Or could it simply be the things they made him draw were in fact who they are instead of what they saw? He scratched his head and thought, what could the answer be? I do not look like them, so I must look like me. Thank you.